Karyn Bryant for MMA Heat. I'm here with Quinton Rampage Jackson. You're basically all anybody's talking about these days.
Why? Why people got my name in their mouth all the time?
Because
already, like
your tweets. Oh, yeah, all the stuff that's going on.
I tweet how I feel. You know what I'm saying? Like, some people don't like it. Who cares? I figure, like, on my Twitter, if you follow me, you're my fan, right? So I'm talking to my fans, but I don't see why people follow you to hate on you. So
yeah.
I don't care about those guys. So I tweet to my fans, the people that, you know what I'm saying, like, I care about. So.
Right. Do you ever tweet drunk?
Fuck yeah.
Okay, that's what I was going to say, because every now and then there's one that comes out. Mm. And then a couple tweets later, you'll say something like, yeah, y'all know I'm just messing with you or whatever.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
you can
yeah.
just kind of tell, like, yeah. you either sobered up or just went yeah. all the way over.
My tweets go from your mama jokes all the way to, like, serious stuff and promoting right. my favorite sponsors and stuff
right,
like that.
Right. So today you were tweeting about your knees. So what happened? You need to get surgery on both of them?
Well, there's no secret that I hurt my knee in the John Jones fight.
Right.
But I was just hoping that one wasn't as bad. So I just ignored it and stuff like that. And then when I was training for Ryan Bader,
yeah.
I was wrestling really hard. My wrestling was really good because Ryan Bader's a great wrestler. And I wanted to show my wrestling skills because when I was training for John Jones, my wrestling skills got better.
Mm-hmm.
And one of my sparring partners, Tyson Jeffries,
yeah.
like one of the best wrestlers I ever wrestled with.
Yeah.
I was beating him in wrestling. I was taking him down. I was slamming him. I was like getting the best of him. Then he upped his game.
Yeah.
And he started kicking my ass like the next week.
Right.
And then I'm like, oh, I came back and I was kicking his ass. And then one day we were sparring boxing with wrestling takedowns. And the wrestling got real competitive because he's a wrestler. You know how sometimes two wrestlers, we go ahead like bulls.
Yeah.
We want it.
Right.
And then he did like this one move. He tried to take me and trip over my leg and he messed it up right then and there. We actually got video footage, and Gary Alexander was going to put it up, but a whole bunch of stuff happened with the. I did an interview in Japan, and he was going to put the video up of me while I was talking, but.
Mm-hmm.
I did an audio interview, but I didn't know he sent it to somebody to type it up in England, and they couldn't hear me or something because I was drinking beer in the studio rapping.
Right.
So I was in my rapping Mac Daddy mode, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I've seen the clips.
And
look good in Japan in the club after the.
Oh, yeah, that was something different. Oh, that's something
it's
different.
Good.
And so he misunderstood me,
yeah.
And he said some stuff like. He said some stuff that I didn't say, and he typed it in. I don't know why this guy would do that,
right.
But that's why I'm kind of shying away from giving interviews and stuff now, because even though so you give an interview, some people take it the wrong way or add mm-hmm. their own stuff on and do.
Of course.
Stuff, yeah.
So when was it John was doing push kicks to your knee or something, right?
Yeah,
what was it?
I thought John push kicked my left knee back, and I thought that move was illegal. He did it a couple times, and that's kind of like. It's a good technique. I'm not taking no one away from John Jones.
Right.
You know, John Jones is the best light heavyweight fighter in the world. Probably one of the best that's ever been.
Right.
He's good. The guy's good.
He's good. He's very good.
But the one of his techniques I really didn't like. I didn't say nothing about it.
Mm-hmm.
It hurt my knees. It kept me from coming in. He
right.
did his job. The way he fight, you go back and watch the pictures. I've been seeing the pictures. Like, when he fought Shogun, he got his fingers like.
Yeah.
He put his fingers in your eye. I just got poked in the eye like. A couple of days before, and you can see it.
Yes.
I think you said something about it.
Yeah, I did. It was right.
And so
yeah.
I was like, oh, like this. Then he kicked my knee back. I was like, that was great. It was the way he executed his game plan was great. Perfect. I'm not taking nothing from him. But the push knee kick. I was really worried about that. Even when I was training for him, I had my guys mimicking that.
Yeah,
stuff.
Yeah.
But there was no way you could prepare for. Like he does it good. It was a really good technique.
And so you were hurt going into the Bader fight, but there was no chance of you pulling out, right?
No, come on.
You don't pull out anyway because that method doesn't work.
I haven't pulled out. Next, I won't fight injured again just because of all the shit that I've been going through
yeah.
and stuff like that. So I don't think the fans deserve that. You know what I'm saying? Like well, my fans deserve it, but I don't think the MMA fans deserve this. You know, I'm not gonna do that for. No more, because like after the fight, that's one of the main reason why I'm upset was I was upset with and planning to leave the UFC
mm-hmm.
because I felt like they knew I was hurt and after the fight, they should have like in the press, they should have like thanked me for not pulling out of the Japan card
right.
and stuff like that, but that's a different story. I'll tell you about that later. But the reason why I didn't want to pull out because everybody knows that the Japanese fans are my favorite fans. Mm-hmm. And I know in Japan, they don't care if you win or lose, as long as you come to fight.
Right.
And I came to fight, you know what I'm saying? And I was in really good shape, but I did the testosterone. Mm-hmm. And I'm shy. I'm not shy I did. I'm happy I did. I'm 25 right. years old now. I got like 10 more years on my fighting thing. So me getting my knee hurt was a blessing in disguise, actually. And so I didn't know it put a lot of water in you.
Right.
It put a lot of weight on me. I got big, and I didn't know it, so I had to cut 22 pounds, and I just couldn't cut the rest.
Yeah.
And I never cut 22 pounds before in my life. It took me 2 days to cut it, and you know what I'm saying. So it was bad. But now, you know what I'm saying, after all said and done, I came out, and I'm always open with everybody on my Twitter or whatever interviews that I'm leaving the UFC, and I just feel like the UFC, they you know, Lorenzo and stuff, they've done really good. They're nice. They're going to pay for my they're going to pay for all my surgeries, and they're really good about that, you know. And but it's just like some things that they're not good about. Like, I don't like how I'm not promoted as the first ever undisputed champion. I just feel like that's kind of thrown up on the bus a little bit, and I just feel like you know what I'm saying, lately I haven't been making the same money. The UFC getting paid more, but I'm making less money. And it's just like, to me, it's like, is it worth it with all the stick I get from the fans and all the type of stuff? So I just want to go and do my own things. I'm designing video games. Yeah. I'm writing movies. I'm making movies.
So you won't fight elsewhere, though? It's not like you're going to look for another promotion?
I didn't say that.
I know you said you wanted to box, but would you do MMA for somebody else?
Yeah, I still do MMA for somebody else. The fans don't really understand me. Like, even though I fight for money, I'm not all about money. If I was all about money, I wouldn't took the A-Team movie, because I keep it real, I don't give a fuck. I only made $100,000 on that movie, you know what I'm saying? Like, the movie, I would have done the movie for free, but the press tour is one thing. They should have paid me $2 million.
Oh, no, they need to pay you for that, because you're in there doing that nonstop.
I know, that was counted in the price. I didn't know that. But at the time, I just wanted to be able to rock. I'm a big kid. So if I was all about money, I wanna jump over all that money I make from fighting to for $100,000, you know what I'm saying? I'm not saying that I make like I'm not the highest paid guy in MMA, but I feel like I should be one of the highest paid guys in MMA because what I bring to the table, you know what I'm saying? I try to excite people. Even if I'm not fighting, I try to just be real entertaining. I think people should respect that, but a lot of people don't.
But you know what they're going to say is, when you start winning some more, we'll start paying you some more. I mean, do you know what I mean?
Well, I don't, you know.
I'm just saying, because I know you said that's the criticism about American fans in general, that they only like it when you're winning, and so maybe that, I don't know, maybe that bleeds into it a little bit. I'm not sure, but I'm just saying from their point of view, maybe that's why they
even
do
when
that.
Even when I was winning, like, I got started getting paid. I've been getting paid less since after I fought Chuck. I've been getting my money been going.
Well, here's the question, though. Do you think any UFC fighter thinks they're getting promoted enough?
Anderson Silva should be complaining more than me. Maybe he is, but it's in Portuguese, we don't understand. You know what I'm saying? Right. If I was Anderson Silva, I would be pretty much upset. Anderson Silva is like one of the greatest of all time.
Amazing, yeah.
An amazing fighter. I think he should be everywhere, promote everywhere.
But see, it seems like and you've said this too, that they'd rather promote the organization than the individual, and that's what you believe? Because, I mean, I really do wonder. I mean, I'm wondering if there's a fighter that says, yeah, I'm satisfied with the promotion.
Well, maybe a lot of money. See, what the problem is, this is what it is. A lot of fans are sheep. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
A lot of fans are sheep. They just go with what they hear, what they told. This is what the problem I had with Joe Rogan recently. They don't know, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of fighters now are fans.
Yeah.
So like the Ultimate Fighter guys and stuff coming in, they're fans. So maybe they would fight for free. See what they don't understand? I never was a fan of MMA. I didn't start fighting because I was a fanboy. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And so I started fighting because, you know, I'm a fighter. I wanted to be a pro wrestler, but you know what I'm saying? God made me a fighter. Mm-hmm. And that's the path I chose. I've seen it, but I didn't watch UFC when I started fighting. One of my friends, Dave Roberts, took me to a fight. And he told me, hey, this is what I'm doing. Come help me train for my fight, because I was a wrestler and stuff like that. And I was helping him training for a fight and wrestling with him and stuff. And you know, somebody pulled out. And then I got thrown into a fight, and I beat the best guy in Memphis. And that's how I started fighting.
But that being said, though, the UFC is part of the reason you got to do. Not that you didn't earn the B.A. Baracus thing, but obviously what you brought, your cachet as a UFC fighter.
Right.
Done a lot for you,
it's not
all bad.
No. Right. I didn't see people misunderstand me.
No, I'm not. I know what you're saying.
You're misunderstanding me too.
I don't misunderstand you. I'm just that testosterone is working, isn't it?
Hey, this testosterone got me horny as hell.
Seriously,
I ain't gonna lie.
At what point did you start taking it? When along the timeline of the Bader fight? When did that happen?
Like when I injured my knee, about a month before the fight.
Oh, okay.
So yeah, I took before the Bader fight, so I took like three shots before the baby.
So you could, you were sucking up what was going on with the John thing. The John knee, you were like, whatever, I can deal.
I felt injured all the time.
Right, right. But the Bader knee, then you kind of
I could. That's the worst injury I ever had.
Is it ACL? Is it, what is it?
I can't remember. I think meniscus.
Yeah, torn meniscus.
What's the question you asked before? You jumped.
I asked if it made you more horny. And
No. Before that, we were talking because I started.
I asked you about the UFC and that it wasn't all bad.
No, okay. You misunderstand me. Yeah. Don't do it because I get punched. No. Like, if we come back to all this other stuff later.
It's okay, yeah.
UFC is not all bad. Honestly, they are great people. It's a great organization, and I don't blame the UFC for promoting the show, because anything that happens to a fighter can get hurt. They can be building up, like Brock Lesnar. They can put all the eggs in their basket and look at him. He's injured, or he's not well, and he can't fight no more. So I understand the UFC for what they're doing and stuff like that, but so I don't want them to blame me for doing what I'm doing, you know what I'm saying? I'm not the UFC, you know what I'm saying? I'm Rampage, and you know what I'm saying? The UFC didn't make me, you know what I'm saying? I come from Pride and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Pride made me, but then Pride, you know what I'm saying, treat me like shit.
Right.
I left Pride. You guys remember, go back and remember, I did the same thing. When I feel like I'm not appreciated, I leave Pride. Because what I do is I go out there and I put my life on the line to make a fight exciting. Mm-hmm. If I get hurt really bad in a fight, get my neck broken and still live and paralyzed, there's no pension for me. Like, it's not like the NFL or the NBA.
Well, because they have fighters, they have unions for the spot.
We don't have any of that. Right. See, the fans don't understand it. A lot of fans are selfish. They think this and think that. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. No, I can't be all like you guys, like a fanboy of the UFC, when, you know what I'm saying, I'm making, like, the money I'm making is good, but I'm putting all four of my kids through college, you know what I'm saying, I'm putting my little sister through college, and I'm you know what I'm saying, my family, they don't understand, I come from a poor family, and when you black, and you got money in a black family,
you're paying for everybody.
My oldest sister, she's like 2 years older than me, and she used to be real fine and sexy growing up. I ain't gonna lie, my sister standing right here, I say the same thing. My family know me. See, y'all don't know me. My family know me. I've been keeping it real since keeping it real was keeping it real.
Right.
That is since I was a little baby. Anyway.
Is it the one I met at Nick's party?
Now she's big. She blew up. She said it's because she had two kids, but I've been living in California for a while.
I had a kid.
I think you don't like, you had nothing. I give you a couple of them. Anyway, but her titties are big as hell now. So she got two, I'm talking about one of her titties. We're not going to go there. Yeah. They big as hell. Some big old juggly.
Take old bitties.
I'm talking about, I beg her to wear a bra. She's like, they don't make them big enough. I'm like, get some buckets or something and strap them to your chest and tie ropes around your back. But anyway, now I got to pay for her titty reduction because I got money. Stay here visiting now. They want to take the kids to Disneyland. She said, I said, okay, I'll give you $1,000. She said, $1,000? You got to give us $1,500 because they're going to go on tours and eat. So I got cousins calling me. I got a cousin that got married to the cousin, and now he calling me. I'm like, hold on, dog. You ain't blood. You ain't blood. He said, I don't care, man. I want some money. You got it. So people don't understand. I mean, people know me and know how I am. Like, you know what I'm saying? I do it for them because I know how it is.
Mm-hmm.
I grew up when we didn't have food to eat. You know what I'm saying? I used to eat onions like apples.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? So straight up.
Yeah.
And so I do that, but I can't keep doing that on the money that I'm making and still trying to do the stuff I like to do because, you know, I like the bling. I like the car.
Nice cars.
I like that stuff. You know what I'm saying? So.
Yeah. No, I do understand.
So let me finish what I'm saying.
Yes.
So I decided to leave the UFC because I just don't feel like they respect what I'm trying to do. Okay, they knew I was injured, and sometimes I don't even tell the UFC that I'm injured. But I'm suspicious. But when I fought Rashard, I injured the same knee, not as bad, but it was pretty bad. And I was filming that 24/7 show, what they called it, prime time. And there's all the cameramen around. And my team in the UK, Wolfler, they didn't say nothing. It was on the internet nowhere.
Yeah.
And he's punching me in my right knee. Like, why is this guy punching me in my right? He knew my knee was hurt. And you know what I'm saying? I fight a lot of fights injured. I fought Shogun injured. Mm-hmm. I fought Chuck injured. I fought Forrest injured. Mm-hmm. I fought Rashad injured. I fight. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
I don't pull out. And I think a thank you should go there instead of, I don't think his head's into it.
Right.
Now people think, I'm gonna clear this up too. I'm so tired of people think, just because I say I don't like to train, don't mean I don't train hard. Now you go back to my fights where I'm not injured, like fights like Dan Henderson. I was not injured for that fight. I was actually pretty good for that fight. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And I train hard. Go back and watch the fight. Dan got tired in the third. I did not get tired.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I train hard. I don't think a lot of people that train harder than me. I know what it takes to kick somebody's ass. You know what I'm saying? And like when I get a fight and it's not a short notice fight and I'm not injured, that's when you see me at my best. Like for like fights like Marvin Eastman, my first fight in the UFC. You know, I train really hard. I just keep it real by saying I don't like training. I'm not a fanboy. I'm not a fan of this sport. Like, I hate getting up, going to the gym 3 times a day, running, doing all that stuff. I hate it because I got all these injuries. Everything hurt. Right. Everything hurts on me. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, I shouldn't be fighting. I should be living somewhere like in the Philippines where, you know, the humidity is so strong, you don't feel no pain.
Right. And so, the ladies are...
Well, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to keep it real. Like, I wasn't really feeling the ladies in the Philippines.
No,
I wasn't really impressed. They're nice. They're really nice there.
Right,
I saw some gorgeous ones and stuff like that. But I have to keep it real. Like, in the Philippines, you don't know what type of lady you get.
Oh, okay, right. It may not be.
It may not. Well, I can tell a lady when I see one, but you don't know what you don't know what type of job she got or what type of job she might used to have.
Right, I hear.
So I'm not. You know what I'm saying?
I hear. But no, I want to get back to the TRT thing because you just said a couple minutes ago, hey, I feel like I'm 25 years old. Oh, here we go. You need to elevate the knee, apparently, right?
Yeah,
you got to do rest, ice, compression, elevation. Mm-hmm. So, you're strong. So, is my husband over there?
Damn.
Wait, he trains, too.
I heard you train 4 times a week. I better watch out, because I ain't training right now. I forgot that. I keep forgetting that the camera you know, he's a cameraman.
4 times a week.
Hey, wait, why are you training 4 times a week? I did your house 4 times a week. You don't go train with him, do you?
No.
How long are you training for? Where y'all live? Okay.
No, but so this is a legitimate argument that people have is that why is it fair for you for some of these older fighters to take hormone replacement so that they're equivalent to a young fighter? Shouldn't there just be a natural progression of aging and the older guys just not fighting anymore? You know what I mean? It's one of those questions of is it fair,
The reason why I took it is because I heard that organizations like to have all the fighters on a level playing field.
Okay,
so my test was really low, and I was told by some doctors to bring it up to 600. My doctor said that I should bring it up to 800 because some guys are naturally at 1100. Like, say a fighter like Chet Kongo. You see how he's ripping stuff all the time? Totally natural and everything.
Right.
But they said he might be 1100 naturally.
Right.
So why should I be at 6?
Right.
So, but I did it fair. I said, okay, I'll be at 6. I don't care. I didn't want mine at what it was. It was really low. And
did you feel like it was low?
Yeah, I could tell. Yeah. I could tell. But I didn't know what was wrong with me.
Right.
I got hurt and stuff like that. And my doctor, Dr. Kessler, I'm sorry, Dr. Kessler. He get mad because I said Dr. Kessler. I go to him first because he's a doctor that he sees me and he automatically get paid by the UFC. He tied it. He called the UFC and tell the UFC what I need when I'm there. The UFC is just I'm not used to it because Pride didn't do this. The UFC pays for everything, and that's what I was saying in the interview where they turned some people saying I went to a UFC doctor or some shit, and he was like. He was like, man, you know, I showed him my MRI. He said, man, I'm going to send you to this knee doctor.
Yeah.
And so like that, he sent me to Dr. Moore. I've been to Dr. Moore before. Dr. Moore is actually a great doctor. And he said, he told me, like, man, you shouldn't fight. He said, you'll heal up. You don't need surgery now.
Right.
But if you don't fight, it'll heal up. And stuff like that. You just rest, stop training, and just call off this fight. And you'll heal up without surgery.
Mm-hmm.
So I was like, man, but what if I go ahead and fight? So you could rip it all the way and stuff like that. Need surgery. And then I went back to Dr. Kessler and told him, he said, well, if you plan on fighting, well, you got to go and meet this doctor right here, Dr. K, he's a Russian guy.
Right.
Very smart. And he said, he'll put you on some, so he had like age management stuff. And he probably knows what to do to make you heal faster. So I did that. I sat down and talked to him and he explained everything to me. I said, now, I don't know anything about steroids, anything about testosterone. Right. I don't know anything about growth hormone. I don't know anything about nothing because I never did that. I just started taking supplements when I got sponsored by
Muscle Farm.
Fat Farm.
Fat Farm. That's the clothes that the rappers used to wear.
I knew it was Farm something.
Yeah.
But anyway,
Muscle Farm.
I gotta elevate this.
But so yeah, but so you feel like it just makes you level and that it's not an advantage. It's not.
As long as you don't abuse it.
Right.
I heard about some fighters abusing it and upping their levels. That's why they fell in tests and stuff like that. But I didn't do that. I stayed right where the doctor told me.
Right.
I got tested. It actually sucked. I had blood tests like every week. It checks my levels and everything, and I made sure I didn't go over the levels.
Right.
And it helped me heal up good enough to go to the fight. Now, it hurt while I was still training for the Rampage fight. But like a couple days before the Rampage fight, I felt really good. I only hurt me when I ran and stuff like that. So I was thinking that I had a good chance of even still winning this fight and doing good in this fight. So I was confident, but I was fighting in Japan. I knew it would be a chance I was going to lose. And who wants to lose two fights in a row? I never lost two fights in a row in my whole career. But I risked that because I love Japanese fans so much.
Well, I tell you what, that poster they made of you, that like Rampage Zilla thing was, I mean, beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Yeah. See, and that's another thing. That's another thing why I'm kind of upset with the UFC, because, you know, they did that and everything. They put me as a co-main event.
Yeah.
Nothing to take away from Frank Arrett and
Bendo.
Who?
Bendo. Ben Henderson. Bendo.
Right, yeah. Oh, I didn't know what they called it. Bendo.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know they called Bendo. Yeah. That's what I was going to say his name. He's in Bendo. Like, bend over. Like, why are you doing that to that guy? He's a nice guy.
He is a nice guy.
Why you call him Bend Over? You call him Bend Over.
Yeah.
His mama is going to hear about that. His mama's a nice lady.
And his wife, Phil McCracken. Or Phil, remember? You know, never mind.
Okay.
You never heard those stupid jokes like the Phil McCrackens and the Bend Over and I'm calling for, you know.
I don't follow MMA.
No, it's not even MMA. It's like an old stupid joke that kids tell. Like, what is your prank calling? Like, who's on the phone? Ben who? Bend Over?
Right.
You know what I mean?
I thought it was making jokes about him and his wife on him.
No.
Okay,
no.
So I don't follow this.
No.
I won't even see this interview. I never.
Hey, speaking of which, remember I told you the other day that our other interview, our infamous has over $2 million. Now, why? $2 million views. Why didn't we make them pay to see that?
We should.
That is money in the bank.
$1 a view.
$1.
Man, we could have split that straight down 60-40.
I should at least get 2/3 because I did more of the work, didn't I?
Well, you do got two more interesting things.
So listen.
Let's go back to that question. You're jumping around.
No, I'm jumping around.
You didn't let me finish my thought.
Okay, finish the thought. About the, yes, they made the poster.
Yeah, okay. They made
the poster. That was their co-main event.
It felt good, but I didn't get paid pay-per-view dollars. Normally when I'm co-main event, I get paid. I make the most of my money off pay-per-view dollars.
Yeah.
And that's what I like. You know what I'm saying? Which fighter want to go out there and fight for less money than what he normally fighting? And I feel like, no disrespect to the main event. Those guys are great. I love those guys. But I didn't know this, but a lot of people were saying, like, after my fight, a lot of Japanese people was leaving.
Oh, really?
Yeah, they was leaving. They didn't want to see the main event. Mm. But that's the crowd.
Right.
That's not the people around the world.
Right.
But that's the crowd. And, you know, I felt like, and they promoted me in Japan with the Godzilla thing, so like that. But, you know what I'm saying? I don't get, like, the promotion. I didn't get the promotion money. Like it felt like, and I also felt like, honestly, I feel like they only had one other pride fight on there. It was Mark Hunt, right?
Right.
And remember, had some Gomi and all those other guys, or whatever. But they only had one other like foreign pride fighter,
right?
And it was Mark Hunt, but he was really from K1. So I feel like, you know what I'm saying? They didn't really want to put me on the show. I had to fight to get on.
Right.
I had to fight, and Dana knew I wanted to get on there.
Right.
Like even when I was getting stitched up, and I asked him. I asked him before that. Then I asked him, like, can I still fight in Japan? He's like, yeah, whatever. And then I had to hear through the grapevine. They was putting me on the Chicago card.
Mm-hmm.
On Fox. And I was like, I don't understand this. And he didn't tell me. And they knew, and they kind of got. And I figured, like, that's why I didn't get pay-per-view, because, you know, I was complaining about not being on the show. Then they give me Ryan Bader, another wrestler. I feel like if you get a fighter like me who's trying to be real exciting and stuff like that, give him somebody who's gonna fight, you know what I'm saying? Who's gonna not try to take him down the whole time and stuff like that. Which is nothing wrong with fighting wrestlers. I'm a wrestler.
Right.
But you know what I'm saying?
But is there truth to the rumor then that you turned down a fight with Stephen Bonner, who is somebody that goes out? Okay, so that's
I asked to fight Stephen Bonner.
He'll stand and bang with
the
you.
The only fight that I ever tried to turn down was Matt Hamill.
Okay, so you just weren't interested.
I wasn't interested in the fight, Matt Hamill.
And you took it, and you even said after, I wasn't that fired up for it.
Right.
Yeah.
I've been keeping it real. 100%. Like, even with the testosterone, I didn't have to give up the information.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I don't care. Like I don't do nothing illegal. You know what I'm saying? I ain't doing nothing illegal. Like, it's just a lot of idiots out there that don't know anything about testosterone. They're sheep. They hear something, and then they say it. They hear this, they hear that. One guy told me, like, TRT is going to make you impotent. Like, if that's the case, no man should be walking around with a hard penis. Because we all got testosterone in us. If you don't got testosterone, you're a chick.
I hear too much testosterone makes you bald. That is one thing I've heard.
Yeah, I think that's part of why men. Yeah. That's probably why men are naturally bald, because if I got too much testosterone in it, like, I'm not putting too much. I'm putting my levels back to where.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
You're just getting it right.
I'm just getting back to where it was. And I'm glad I did that. You know what I'm saying?
So listen,
You have some pretty teeth.
Thank you.
I love your lips.
Oh my. Shogun, you, hello, Karyn, focus. You're supposed to be fighting Shogun.
Right.
So that was going to be the rematch 2005. Yeah. You want a rematch.
Yeah.
That's going to have to wait now, right?
Yeah.
Do you feel that that's maybe a bit of an aggressive fight to take right after knee surgery? Because we know Shogun with his Muay Thai, with his kicks, with his knee, I mean, he can be brutal.
Yeah.
You still feel good about that, though, yeah?
Yeah. Because, hey, the first time I fought Shogun, I was injured. I dislocated my ankle 3 weeks into the training camp.
Yeah.
So I couldn't run for the last 3 weeks.
Right.
So my cardio was really bad, and it was like we had 10 minute rounds.
Mm-hmm.
So that always hunted me. I love Shogun. He's a good mm-hmm. guy. When we see each other, we conversate and stuff like that. Yeah. And him and his brother Ninja, they're great guys. And me wanting to rematch Shogun is nothing personal. It's like to myself, because Shogun was coming up. He was the best back then, and I knew I could beat him. You know what I'm saying? I knew I could beat him, but it's just unfortunate I didn't have sparring partner back then, so we hired this kickboxer. He's a big, fat motherfucker. If you watching this shit, I'm talking this shit about your motherfucking ass. I can't even remember your name. But this motherfucker sparring me. I'm paying this motherfucker to spar me, and when I go to punch him, he do like a dirty trick where he kick you low on your ankle. When I'm punching him,
yeah,
he leans back and kick you low on your ankle. And he fucking, like, damn near broke my ankle. And so it was like, so that's 3 weeks before the damn fight.
Right.
And so it hunted me for years. And
because
Shogun, you know, I get injured in that fight. Shogun, like, breaks the muscle in between my ribs. And he crashes me. Like, I call it, he jumped on me.
Because
I was going to try to take it slow, because first round 10 minutes. I knew I didn't have cardio. So I got to live with that. Like, I see that, and then made my coach break up after that, because my coach knew I was hurt. But I guess he thought I was just copping out because I was hurt. And he cussed me out. And from the corner. And my family gets upset at me because this guy cussed me out while I'm getting hurt and stuff like that. So all this stuff happened and stuff behind that. And I just feel like, you know what I'm saying, I want to get that fight back. And I, you know, you can beat somebody, you know?
Yeah.
Like, I know I can beat Rashard. I wish I could rematch Rashard and Forrest. Like, I want to rematch all my losses. Like,
right.
like when I finally beat Manalay, like, I trained with the right people. I joined them with Lair. They had the training camp right and everything. And I had great sparring partners. And I know if I get my training camp right and I come in without an injury,
yeah,
I could win. But I was injured for Venelay. I got injured like the last day of sparring. I got my jaw fucked up. But I kept fighting.
You kept going. Well, are we good?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We're good. Okay. Yeah. Everybody's good. So we're here in Hollywood right now. So what are you doing in the meantime then? What are you going to be able to do while you're recuperating? What do you want to do? What are you lining up so that Quinton has a career when you're done fighting?
Well, I can't tell you everything I'm doing because some stuff is a secret.
Yeah.
But I'm doing a lot of stuff. It's been in the works even before I even made this decision.
Mm-hmm.
But I guess the secret's out that I'm rapping. I've been rapping for actually 7 years.
Yeah.
I almost got recorded in Japan with Pride, because Pride used to do movies, music, and fights.
Yeah.
And but I still stayed in contact with the same producer that I was working with there in Japan. And I did a concert the same night of my fight. I had an after party planned where I was going to do a concert, and whether I won or lost.
Right.
It's just how I am. And so I did that, and Japan didn't know. They didn't know that I could rap.
Because
I never really said anything.
Yeah, yeah.
And I never let none of my stuff go public, because, you know, 7 years, it wasn't that good.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm getting better. It started as a hobby.
Yeah, well, there's that clip out right now that people can see after the fight in Japan. Somebody put up, you know, going, and you got your shirt off and you're on the bar.
I was
and
drunk.
You got what were you drinking? What is it? Jack or something?
Wait, Moet.
No, was it?
I get really drunk off champagne.
Do you? That's a chick drink, though, no?
No, I'm from Memphis. We drink Moet.
Oh, yeah, Moet. Right. I'm sorry. I thought it was for chicks.
No, it's champagne for niggas.
That's true. I guess the rappers are always talking about the Cristal.
I don't follow what other. I'm not a sheep.
You're not a sheep.
I'm a wolf. That's what I've been trying to tell people. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm a wolf. I eat sheep. And you know what I'm saying? A lot of MMA fans are sheep, and that's why I'm upset with them. I love my fans.
But I was just gonna say, you still have a solid core for sure. That's
Whoever. Right. Listen. I'm gonna say it right here, right now. Fans kind of get this misunderstood. Like, I didn't start fighting to have fans.
Yeah.
When I first started fighting, MMA wasn't popular. I started fighting to feed my damn family.
Mm-hmm.
And I still been keeping it real like that. Like, you'll get mad at a doctor because a doctor, he wants to help people, but at the same time, he wants to have a nice house and, you know what I'm saying, and take care of his family. So fans think they bother me when they say, oh, you just fight for money. Anybody say they don't fight for money, they full of shit. Mm-hmm. And they don't say, like, I love my fans. fans, but I don't love all the fans. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Even though I love everybody on the planet, but I'm just saying, I don't love all the fans. And I don't care if I got one fan. If I got one fan, I'm going to love the hell out that one fan.
Right.
I can have a million fans. I'm going to love the hell out of my million fans. But fans are like, oh, I'm no longer your fan. I'm like, good riddance. Then less people ask me for pictures while I'm fucking eating or with my family and bother me. Thank you. Go. I don't care. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm not going to cry.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Don't take it the wrong way, but if you do take it the wrong way, then fuck you too. I don't care.
Well, I do believe, and I know this for us, that the perception of that everybody in MMA is like making bank and everybody's getting rich and stuff like that. And it's actually a very difficult sport to make money in.
Man, boxers, look, we got Pacquiao and Mayweather crying over like what, 100 million or something like that?
Yeah.
Come on, man. Let me cry over 100 million.
No kidding. Let me cry over 100 million and fight two rounds and then dance for another eight or whatever.
Look at it. This is what I'm saying. Boxing is not exciting. Pacquiao is a very exciting.
Mayweather
is a very exciting, but
yeah.
Okay, those two that I can think of top of my head. I don't watch a whole lot of boxing.
Marquez brothers are good. I don't know them.
See, I'm just saying if I hear Pacquiao fighting or Mayweather fighting, I'm gonna watch it. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
But I don't know a whole lot of other boxers, but that's what I'm saying. But some boxers, sometimes you watch, it's boring. And MMA is more exciting, but we get paid less money. It's more risk in MMA. You're getting more people getting hurt. Like, you don't hardly ever hear about a boxer pulling out a fight. Right. They don't happen that much. Maybe you get a cut, stuff like that. But a lot of fighters, like GSP, he hurt and stuff like that. It's a lot of ways to get hurt in MMA.
Yeah.
But there's not that many ways to get hurt in boxing. You get knocked out before your fight, stuff like that. But I'm pretty sure some of those guys don't say nothing when they see a fight. But MMA is more exciting than boxers, and I'm sure that UFC is making just as much money as those guys. Those guys are generating $100 million.
Right.
I'm sure UFC is generating that type of money.
Okay.
I'm sure. I'm not stupid.
Yeah.
That's what people misunderstand. Like, you know, I joke around and stuff like that. I'm not stupid. I'm sure MMA is generating that type of money. But you know what I'm saying? I'm making. I don't want to say what I'm making because the UFC may get mad. You know what I'm saying? But what y'all think I'm making, you might be wrong. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, it's public stuff that I'm making. You know what I'm saying? And that's what I'm making. But that's not where I make money. Like, off other things. You know what I'm saying? And other things.
Do you
like
have money for lotion? You're looking a little ashy.
That's messed up. Because I did put lotion. But that's messed up. I'm mad at you now. Anyway. So let me finish saying this. All I'm saying is, damn, I'm looking at boxers making all this money, and ain't nobody getting knocked out. Nobody hitting the ground. Nobody doing this. And then now, you know what I'm saying, MMA is real exciting. I'll try to be excited as hell, but this is one reason why I want to leave UFC, because look at this. All these fighters come with these extravagant game plans. Going, so it's getting boring too now. MMA evolves a lot. And people just say, oh, you want dimensions. These new sheep that didn't watch my fights back in the day. They didn't watch my fights in pride. They didn't watch this. Yeah, I'm one dimension. Yeah, I'm trying to knock folks out because I don't want to be like those guys game planning, wrestling people, humping them, doing like that. If I don't want to throw leg kicks, you don't know why I'm not. Maybe my knees are bad. Maybe this wrestler don't want to take me down. You know what I'm saying? I ain't throwing leg kicks. No. Some fighters I might throw leg kicks in. And I noticed I started getting the thing in my head, like, oh, let me leg kick this guy. Because, I leg kick Matt Hammer, so I almost got taken down.
Yeah.
And sometimes, you know what I'm saying, you get taken down. It's hard to get up off the ground if a guy just holding you.
Yeah.
If you guys doing jiu-jitsu, going for stuff like that, I can get up all day. But if a guy just holding me down,
right,
let me hold you down right now and see if you can get up.
Sure.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
If I was going for something, you get holes and stuff to get up.
Right.
But if this guy just holding you,
right,
just laying on you, I won't see anybody get up. He may throw a punch here and there and say busy, but people know how to do this. But the MMA fans are sheep. They knew. UFC got a lot of new fans.
Mm-hmm.
They don't know what the hell they watching. They just see this guy on the ground not getting up. And they see this other guy working a little bit. This guy may hold you for most, then he'll punch you here and there. People know how to do this. It's a game plan just to hold people down. And I don't want to be a part of that.
Mm-hmm.
I want to fight people like Shogun, people like Vanderlei, people like Chuck, you know what I'm saying? Like the real fighters. Like, look at guys like Frank Edgar and Bend Over. You know what I'm saying? Those guys are soldiers.
They went to war.
Yeah. That's how MMA should be. That's what made MMA popular. But look at these guys like John Jones and, Rashard Evans and all the guys at Jackson. You know what I'm saying? I heard.
Did you see the Carlos Condit Nick Diaz fight?
You know what I'm saying? It's kind of frustrating for me to watch. And then I heard even Clay Guida's getting boring now. I couldn't imagine that. And I'm a big fan of Clay Guida, but somebody told me that. I didn't see it.
His last fight against Ben Henderson was a good fight.
Well, I didn't see it. I'm just saying. Maybe I'm wrong. Scratch that comment. But I'm just saying. Somebody somebody was saying that he ain't fighting the same one no more.
He started doing more of the wrestling for a while. I think he's actually getting back to.
Okay, more of the what I'm saying. That's what somebody was telling me when I was saying so, because I haven't been able to watch fights. I was like, I'm too busy playing video games and messing with women.
So are you happy though, Quinton? I mean, are you? I know there's a lot of turmoil and there's a lot of stuff that could be going better for you, but I mean, in terms of your answer,
I'm doing movies. I'm writing movies because I like to do stuff like that. I'm designing video games. I got a video game coming out pretty soon called Rampage. It's something we put out really fast.
Yeah.
It's going to be like, like one of those app games.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and then now they got this PS Vita.
Okay.
That new
thing.
Yeah, I got like three of them. I got them in Japan. Like, nice, I've been playing them, you know what I'm saying? I've been waiting for something like that to come out. So these games I got in my head, I can put on there. So I'm going to do that. Then I got some other business ventures that I'm coming out with. I just don't want to talk about those yet because I don't want someone to try to go and swoop them, you know what I'm saying?
I get a little jerky when I see that move.
But, you know, I be inventing stuff. People don't know that. I be inventing things. I invented this text machine I wanted you to try out.
I don't think so.
You don't think so? Your husband, that's what research. Listen, I didn't say with me. I didn't say with me.
Well, give me one. You can mail one to us.
Oh,
can I watch y'all use it? Because I'm just for research. Can I watch y'all use it?
No.
Well, it's for research.
Yeah,
it's a sex machine. It's a really good one. Dog is hat. Help you with the dog is hat. You know how sometimes.
Help you with it? Do people really need help with that?
Some girls need help with dogs.
Oh, really?
Maybe they too low or they're too. Some girls taller and, you know, guess we're talking about that.
Yeah, that's off not camera. Really. Yeah. So, yeah. Sorry. Well, I wish you the best, obviously, you know that. And I hope that the knee surgery goes okay. You know, you should go. Shogun's guy is right down the street, actually, at Cedars. The guy that did his knee was really pretty good.
I got some really good doctors.
I'm sure you do.
I got faith in my doctors. So,
I'm sure you do.
So, I got great doctors.
And do they give you a time frame as to when you could possibly be a back connection?
He actually told me that the knee is not as bad as he thought it would be if I fought. Because Bader only hurt my knee when he took me down at one time. After I slammed him, he took me down and I landed on my stomach. My knee just hit the canvas and stuff like that. So it's not like it didn't hurt. Right. It just banged against the canvas.
Right.
And so that was not that bad. And my left one, he thinks that I just got a scope. I got to get an MRI on the left one now. Because I wasn't even going to deal with the left one, but my manager told me just go ahead and get both of them. But I don't want to get surgery on both knees at the same time.
No, that would be hard.
I know. So he says microscopic, and so it's not that bad. So I won't be out that long.
Yeah, I mean, the stuff they do, they're amazing at it.
Yeah.
It's not.
Yeah, it'll be my first surgery and stuff, so I'm kind of nervous about it, but I'm going to do it. I'm going to be strong, and I'm finish my contract with the UFC. They actually been really cool with me and stuff like that. They talked to my manager and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I'm sad to... I'm sad to leave the big show and stuff like that, but people don't understand me, you know what I'm saying? Like, at the end of the day, you know, I feel like I'm not being respected and appreciated, and that's where if the UFC offered me $20 million a fight, I'd be like, okay.
Well, that's what I was just going to say. What if you absolutely kicked Shogun's ass, and then they were like, yo, Quentin,
accidentally?
No, I said actually.
Straight up. When I get my knee back together, straight up, I'm training my ass off. I got something to prove to Shogun. I don't care if I'm just coming out of knee surgery or something like that. I'm going to give Shogun a run for his money. Shogun go out to, you know what I'm saying, wake up pretty early to train pretty hard for me for this, because I know how to train hard, you know what I'm saying? Like, when I was training for John Jones, that was the best Rampage ever, and that's why I give John Jones his praise. I never lost a fight being in that type of shape. Never lost a fight being in that type of shape, and he beat me quite easily. And then he submitted me. I haven't been submitted since Shaka Rabo, so. You know what I'm saying? Let y'all know, I was training jiu-jitsu, but I did one thing wrong with John Jones. I trained with a tall guy, so I didn't do jiu-jitsu with a tall guy.
Yeah. The limbs, it's the leverage and all that.
Yeah, I didn't think about that. The tall guy that we had, he's a boxer and a kickboxer. His ground is okay, but he's not like John Jones.
I think wrap your legs, I mean, it's...
Yeah, it's different, but I'm prepared for this stuff now. I think that, you know what I'm saying, like, especially with this testosterone, I think that I'm going to be good. I think I got 10 more years. I was actually thinking about retiring after the John Jones. I had all these injuries. I'm not going to raffle off all my injuries because I don't want my opponents to know. That's why I never talk. That's why I never talk about them. But I got a lot of things in my body that's, you know what I'm saying, that needs help. But you know, I'm noticing that they're healing up now that I'm on testosterone and stuff. But
would you ever do the pro wrestling now?
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, I do that. I do whatever. I got a lot of stuff that up my sleeve. I got a lot of ways I want to entertain the fans. And you know, if you want to watch it, watch it. If you don't. Don't.
Listen, nobody can ever deny that you're, like, the most entertaining guy to come out of the UFC, so. Well, not that he, and they didn't make you. I know that. You made you. You made you.
Right.
But thanks for it.
Yeah, thank you. Hey, I do what I do for the fans. I you know, if there's a camera around me or not, I'm going to be the same way. Like, the most of the funnest things I do, no one ever sees it except for the person with me.
Right.
Something like that. And that's never, so I actually had a camera guy follow me around for a while, something like that, and sometimes his ass don't get the camera on. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, oh, it's all. So I'm going to start doing a whole bunch of stuff and just stay out there and just keep entertaining my fans. So, because I feel bad that I had to leave the UFC, but, you know, I just want same reason why I left Pride. Once I had a meeting with Yukino and Hideki, it was like, they were like the American president, and they told me I was a nobody. And I left Pride after that. When my contract was done, they wanted me to sign another contract. I said, no, I'm a nobody. Peace. I'm Hollywood. Don't downplay me and what I am, because I do a whole lot for the sport, and I do it to be excited and stuff like that. I go beyond my personality, and just, I don't clam up when the camera on and stuff like that. I just show my personality and go beyond just to be excited for the fans. And when I fight, you know, so I always come to fight no matter what. I always just wrestle if I'm not excited about fighting. So I still try to go and give an exciting fight. And no matter who it is or why I win or lose, I don't care. At the end of the day, I don't care about winning or losing. American fans are the ones that care and want to talk shit and try to say I suck and stuff like that. But for all you fans to talk shit and say I suck, I'll give you the address to my gym. You guys come down to the gym and come say it in my face in the cage after you sign a waiver.
Oh my God.
If you think I suck, come. I'm serious.
I know. I mean.
I do it before I get a knee surgery. You think I suck, come on down to my gym, step in the cage with me, and show me that I suck. And if you beat my ass, I say, okay, I suck. But if I beat your ass, I'm going to kick you the fuck out of my gym. Get the fuck out. You suck. So fans can say whatever they want. See, because they don't know me. They don't know what type of person I am. You know what I'm saying? I'm like Jay and Silent Bob. I will find your address. That's, you know what I'm saying? So.
Totally. That's good. Well, you don't suck. You certainly don't.
Do you?
I'm still here.
Oh. No, you don't suck. You actually pretty good at reporting and stuff.
Thank you, Quinton. I think we should probably wrap that up.
Hey, I was just saying, you know.
Who's your favorite reporter?
Yeah.
Karyn Motorboat. That's her name is in my cell phone.
Oh, no way. That's so bad.
I don't know your last name.
It's Bryant, like Kobe.
Oh, yeah. Karyn Bryant. I got to change it now. No, I got a couple other Karens. My son's grandmother's name is Karyn.
Yeah. Okay.
So, it's spelled the same way. I don't want to be calling her a thing. I'm you, you know, vice versa. So listen, since the other one got 2 million, I think we should try to get this one.
No.
How about a random humping?
No humping. No motorboating.
Motorboat me then.
No.
Come on.
I can't.
Take the chain out.
Oh my God.
We want to get this one at 2 million viewers. We can charge $1 for this one. I need some. I'm gonna need all the money I can get. I ain't gonna be fighting no more for a while. Come on, I'm turning to a male prostitute. Except for the fat women. I'm sorry, fat women. Like, if you try to hire me, I won't do my job right because when you're fat, I'm sorry, it just won't come up. I'm sorry. He got a mind of his own. I'm sorry. So I'm gonna be a male prostitute. I'm gonna have to sell myself a little bit because I ain't gonna be fighting that much. I'm probably fighting a little small show for $50. You know what I'm saying? As long as they say thank you. When I fight in your little small show. And if I do a good job, and I make everybody laugh, and give you a good interview, and I give you a good side fight where I win and lose, you know what I'm saying? Just say, thank you. We appreciate that you didn't back out of this fight when you was injured or you know what I'm saying? You the man. Like, I wish more fighters had a mentality like you, or thank you for this. And don't question if my head's into it or you know what I'm saying? And think that he you know, he's over it or his mind's on a movie and stuff like that. Just because I do a movie don't mean that I'm not interested in MMA no more. That means that I want to do a movie. I want to be a big kid. I want to have a career. I get done fighting. You know what I'm saying? It's just weird how people try to limit you to just one thing. Like, yes, I'm a fighter. Yes, I am. But I'm not only a fighter. I'm a father. You know what I'm saying? I'm an uncle, sister. Am I a sister?
Sister.
Okay, I'm not a sister.
So.
I'm not.
No.
I was hoping I was somebody's sister. Can I be a sister?
I don't know. I could use a sister. Mm-hmm. What do you want?
Okay. No, I'm not a sister. I guess I'm a cousin.
A cousin?
Am I an auntie?
No.
Grandma? No. Okay.
Grandma.
No, okay.
Grandma.
I'm not a granddad or grandma or auntie or nothing like that. But I do a whole lot of stuff. I'm not just a fighter. You know what I'm saying? Just don't label me just as one little small thing and you can enjoy me more. except for fat women. Y'all can't enjoy me at all. I love you, though. I love you, fat women. I do.
Well, your sister. You love your sister.
I do. I love my sister. My sister's fat in the motherfucker, but I love the hell out of her. I love all 345, 90 pounds of her.
Why can't you get her to come to your gym? Why won't she work out with you?
We don't want fat people like that, right? I'm joking. We don't want people to
bad for, it's bad for young business.
It's bad for business. No, I'm joking. She don't live in California. She live in Memphis. Memphis.
It's the food down there.
Listen, my sister used to be a fine young little tenderoni. All my little friends used to be all up on there and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Now I can't pay my friends even hug up on them. She got a crush on Congo, too. And I'm like, Congo's like, mm-hmm. I hope she don't see this interview.
Well, Quinton, I could talk to you all day, but I know you need to go get dinner.
Yeah, I gotta eat. I haven't eaten nothing all day.
I know.
I've been so busy. I just did voiceovers for the movie I did with 50 Cent and Bruce Willis and
what's
Josh
Duhamel.
Fire with Fire. I just had a little small role in it, and I just had to do the voiceovers. It's funny. I just thought that it's
cool.
Funny. I had the funniest line in the whole movie.
When does it come out?
Hell if I know. But they're getting it ready for getting ready now. So they maybe coming out soon. I'll let y'all know.
Cool.
All right. I'm just gonna take off.
All right. Thank you.